Thank you. once again. It's been a long, long time. Haven't felt like this before, since can't remember when. It's been a long, long time. You'll never know how many dreams I've dreamed about you, or just how lonely they all seem without you. So kiss me once, kiss me twice, kiss me once again. It's been a long time.
Okay, guys, this will not be something you want to just turn on and listen to because I'm going to talk. You guys are talking and you're making good comments. Keith, you are not this old. I'm this old. I love this era of music. It is the old traditional jazz standards, the American songbook stuff. Man, I just love it. You ask for Night and Day. And the trouble with Night and Day and most Cole Porter stuff is if you miss that first key sequence, chord sequence, I never can get it back. And I have tried to commit it to memory, but I have not succeeded. Okay, can we just make believe we're all sitting in my living room and we are not being recorded or anything like that? Maybe I won't post this. That'll get me off the hook, won't it? Ooh, I got a card. Mercy. Let me see. I think I have it in one of these books. I actually bought a Cole Porter book, but where to find it right this minute? Oh, look at there. Okay, I don't know that I can do it, but... Thank you. verse is the prettiest part of that, I think. And it didn't have the verse written, and I would not begin to, I don't think I'd begin to try it. Okay, so I'm completely lost now. I don't know old 1937. Loverly. Don't I love Loverly? I love everything from My Fair Lady. There are several that I love though.
Thank you.
I love this because I'm a word person. Hey, Vera.
Thank you.
Y'all have to admit, that's, I hope it's fun for y'all. It's fun for me. Forgive me, y'all. It's parched time here in South Carolina. The weather's been really, really pretty, but the pollen is still crazy. I think somebody asked for this. If not, somebody asked for it, please.
Thank you.
drives me crazy. Okay, it'll come to me. Anyway, I was trying to play a few of my favorite things. The title of the song, not a few of my favorite things. I should not try to be humorous. Let's see. Oh, my friend Jan Ford, who's going to direct the choir for our hymn sing, asked for this one, and if she's going to sing pretty, I have to play pretty, so... So, to me, it's so pretty musically. Thank you. get requests every time I play this kind of music. I get requests for Unchained Melody, which I cannot remember, and I know it. And you guys, when you play by ear, it's all up to whatever happens in my brain. If I can't remember it, I just can't remember it. But I don't know Red Sails in the Sunset, and I get requests for that every time. So I've got to go look that up. So I will work on that. And oh, Sandy, it had to be you. Yeah, I'll butcher it, but I'm going to try it because I do love it. And another one that I love that I'll butcher is Imagination. Rachel, don't let me forget Summertime. Anything Gershwin that I can play, I dearly love. But can we have coffee chat? Can we have smart water chat? The Sacred Music CD, and I've talked some. I'm going to move this church hymnal. I think some of you think it's sacrilegious, and I can't put it on the floor because you'd never do that to the church hymnal. The Sacred Music CD that we went to Nashville and recorded in February and March, early March. I talked with Kevin Williams this week, and we're thinking that it's going to be the middle of June. He's working on the master, and we're just now starting to work on the cover, but I am probably as excited right this minute over what the potential that the cover has as I am the CD itself. Have you ever just had those things that felt ordained, even though it wasn't necessarily a sacred thing? It was like, oh God, you gave me this. I've struggled with what the CD cover should be and the content, because you know I love words, and I want to set the stage for the CD, because it's not something I think everybody's just going to go wild over. I think it's going to be something that you just turn on and you forget it's on because you're just living and maybe you're humming. But anyway, I won't say any more about that. I'll just say that I think the CD will be ready to release sometime around the middle of June. That's as close as I can, and as close as I can gauge it right now. What I'm also really excited about, and I don't want you guys to get the wrong idea, I don't know what this page is going to become. I love my job. I love the career that I have. I feel like it's God's gift to me. I don't want to do anything that steps outside of His path. As you've heard me say, my path has been very serpentine. His path is very linear, and my path should be at best, or at least, parallel to His, if not projected on to His path for me. But my path has been very serpentine, and I'm trying so diligently to hear His voice and follow what He wants us to do. And if He wants this page to be a viable ministry, there has to be some level of business associated with it. So I don't want you guys to think that we're becoming commercial. We have to approach this from a business sense. I don't ever foresee a time when I'm not sitting at this piano doing at least weekly, sing-alongs and hymn sings and worship times for us. There's no greater purpose for me than that moment. But we have to do things that will create an opportunity for us to grow and for you to grow with us, so that we can minister to more people. I don't know how to say it other than that. If God's happy with the followers that we have, I'm happy with that. If He wants our reach to be further, I'm happy with that. I want to be sensitive to that, but not be impersonal or commercial. I dislike the word capitalist because so many people have made it so negative, but we have to create profits to buy things that we need to buy. I hope there'll be a day when I have to make a decision that my office hours that I do for my career now decrease so that I can spend more time doing this. I never dreamed of this, never imagined it, it's all brand new to me, but I thank you for the support that you've given me. You've made me feel like that, well, maybe there's something here that the world does need to hear, however many people the world is. But I said all that to say, Kimberly has helped us develop a logo, and I am really, really excited about that. And we'll probably do some t-shirts with the logo on it or something like that, maybe even before the CD comes out. And you know, I'm not asking you for money. I hope, for goodness sakes, there'll never be a day when that is. But if you want to be a part of a bigger part of what we're doing, and you want to have someone stop you and say, what does that logo mean? And you're able to share the ministry of the gospel. Maybe it'll open a door for salvation. Then that's all we're wanting. I'm not wanting one thing more than that. So the reason that I said all of that is you're talking about a CD number two, Kevin. I saw you say CD number two. Before I left Nashville, I actually talked with Kevin Williams about a couple of CDs. And we talked about this kind of music on the next CD and then Christmas on the next one. But it's all going to depend on how well the first one is received. And I'll be honest with you, because I have no idea how the CD sales will be. And I'm not asking you to buy a CD. If you're compelled to, I would be thrilled. I really did this as a legacy project for Madison, my daughter, and for my family to have in case something happened to me, that there would be something that would, my music could live on beyond my life. And I think that's what we all do a lot of those kinds of things for. But anyway, CD number two, if we do that, may very well be a jazz standards, American songbook kind of CD, lots of kinds of things like that. And the third one, if we're so blessed to do that, will probably be a Christmas one. So anyway, we got to get busy. Anyway, I'm sorry. I hate saying, we had a professor that we would actually count the number of times he said, to help us get through his class. So I want to use my words carefully and not use fillers, because that's distracting. Regardless, there's a filler. It's also a segue. I saw someone request Moon River. I absolutely love Moon River. I took voice, if you can believe that when I was in college for one semester, and I had an amazing voice professor, and I actually sung Moon River as my recital piece. So it's really important to me. How long have I been on, guys? There I go. I don't want to be too long. I don't want to bore you. So Moon River. Thank you. from South Carolina. I love this song. You may not even know it.
Thank you.
that's what happens when you play by ear. It just left me. I know what it does, but anyway. And it left me because I saw another song that I started in my head, and I should have been shot for doing that. Okay, so what did I see? Oh, here it goes. Let me put these books down, y'all. I'm sorry. Makes me think of this because this is sort of where I am, my stage in life. And if you don't know the words, "This is time in a bottle," look it up and you'll know what I mean. Thank you. Okay, for Kevin and Kathy, I won't put any last names, but you might figure out who they are. Anyway, they're some dear people who have been mighty kind to me. This is for them to dance to, and anybody else. If you got somebody in the room with you, nobody's looking, dance. If you don't have somebody, do like me, grab your broom or grab a towel and wrap it around the door handle. That's how I learned to do the South Carolina shag, and I'm not very good at it, but anyway.
Thank you.
any of those John Denver songs, y'all. I'm so sorry, and I love John Denver. When I was a teenager, I got told all the time, I guess I had similar glasses or something and long hair, and or whatever hair you call it. They said I got called John Denver many times, but anyway, I think I could do this. Okay, guys, can I leave now? Please. As my uncle used to say, I need to go to bed so y'all can go home. Oh goodness, there's so many more that I'd love to play. I don't play this music often enough to really play it with a great deal of agility. I'm really struggling, and I hope you can't tell it, but I really struggle with a lot of the chord sequences because I just don't play them that often anymore. But I do love them, and I'm going to play them more because I've got to choose about a dozen if we're going to do this CD, and from what it sounds like, you guys would be interested in it. So I guess maybe we'll begin to pursue it. Hey, Miss Glenda, yeah, watch it while you're doing something like blow drying your hair or something. Sit under a hair dryer. What is this song? Lionel Richie. I heard it. I haven't heard past that. Because that'll be your earworm until you go pull it up on YouTube or something and play it so you can get it out of your head. Woo, mercy. That was bad. I'm sorry. I love Lionel Richie stuff, and some of them sound the same. It's very similar, and I can get in the middle of them and get really, really screwed up. Somebody asked for Wind Beneath My Wings, and I get to a point in that song where I just get really tripped up, but I'll try it. Thank you. And I get in the middle of it because I don't ever play it and just get lost. So accept it with flaws. Ugh. Okay, I wish I could think of something just to throw you all off completely, other than a nightcap. Oh, y'all are so kind. My goodness. Thank you. I'm just sitting here goofing off at my piano, and you're just sitting here with me. So lots of mistakes, but lots of fun, I hope, and lots of good memories. If there's anything that I've learned in my 60 years, it's that the years go by way too quickly, and we need to take advantage of every moment we can to enjoy each other's company and enjoy the presence of God. As a prelude to our eternal life, where we'll enjoy His presence and each other's presence forever. Isn't that a wonderful thought?
Thank you.
Okay, last song. And let me know. I've talked so much, I always feel guilty about saving and posting the songs, the videos where I talk a lot. But again, this is just us on Saturday night, sitting here in my living room. So anyway, let me know if you want me to. Oh, Sheila, thank you so much. You should be here singing. You and Donna should be here singing with me. Kevin, I don't know. I know Candles in the Wind, but I don't know it to play it. So, and Elton John's music, unless you really fram the piano, it's not the easiest stuff to play. I only learned that one song of his because Madison, I played it for Danielle to sing at Madison's wedding reception. And it really has become a wonderful, wonderful song. I love the words. How wonderful life is now that you're in the world. Okay. Miss Bullock, you might be the only one that loves it when I talk. Most people send notes and say, don't talk so much, just play. Song in the middle of all of that, because if you think about Bridge Over Troubled Waters, there's never been any greater, if you project that onto our spiritual life, God is the bridge over troubled waters. And my dear friend who I just reconnected with a couple of Sundays ago, Miss Vera Howell, Vera is one of the most beautiful, elegant ladies, and I loved when we all attended church together and I got to accompany her. But I told her for me, this was her signature song, the Dottie Rambo song, I Will Glory in the Cross. And what a great song. I'll come back and play Misty if you all won't feel like that's sacrilegious. I don't think Jesus will have a problem with that. He's probably grinning, wondering how I'm going to make it fit. So, but I'm going to play this just for Miss Vera. I boast not of works or tell of good deeds, for naught I have done to merit his praise. All glory and honor rest upon him. Unworthy to die in my stead, I will glory in the cross. What amazing words. If you know the words of that, post them as I play it. It's just amazing, amazing words. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
this should be the closing one.